access to care?
I don't really know if I can make any useful comments right now because I'm like tired and I want to go to sleep. Well, it was kind of entertaining, and I can't say funny because it wasn't. So I'll give it to 7. Oh, that's a lot.
7?
Yeah.
That's quite acceptable.
It is. Okay.
I like the plot line. I like the character development. It was interesting. So I was also
going to
say
7. Yeah, it's a good film. It's kind of low-key, which is quite nice. And it's a kind of revenge story, which gives a lot of kind of power. But it sort of lacks a little bit of the gloss that you sort of associate with a Bond movie. So I've never particularly liked it, but I'm actually going to increase my rating of it. Up to a 7, because that's higher than I've ever regarded it before. And
if we just do pan across slightly, we're not gonna witness Joseph get hit on the head.
What for?
Don't you want to know why?
Yes, very big Bond movie. Awesome Bond, I dig the guy. And awesome girl, I like that girl. She's nice and pretty, and I think she played her role really well. So I'll have to give it something like a 9.5. Enjoyed it, it's awesome.
I think GoldenEye, probably to our generation, is probably about as iconic as Goldfinger is to the 60s generation, so definitely a very memorable film. And Pierce Brosnan, I think, is good in the role. He kind of brings together kind of the best of Connery, Dalton, and Roger Moore. So it's good from that point of view. The story, or the film, it has its flaws, but I think it's actually so memorable that you kind of overlook them. So 9/10.
Yes! I am invincible!
Does.
What? Let's Die Never Die.
Oh, flip, I was thinking of Die Another Day. Anyway, Tomorrow Never Dies. Good movie, I must say. I enjoyed it a lot. Very, very entertaining. I dig Alan Cover, he's a good bloke.
Hey! Hold up! Hold up! Hold up! Hold up! Hey! 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 Who you are?
Pathetic. I'll have to give it an 8. It was awesome, I would say, yes.
There's nothing really wrong with Tomorrow Never Dies, but I just don't think it's a memorable film. Most of it is okay, but yeah, the end sequence on this Delta boat I've never liked. I find it just a little bit boring, unimaginative, and just sort of blasting guns and rockets and stuff. But definitely watchable. I think the villain's pretty good, and a few of the action scenes are very good. I like the bike chase, and the opening sequence of the terrorist arms market is also very cool. I think one of the better pre-credit sequences. So I'll give the film 6.5/10.
I enjoyed the movie, except I think Christmas Jones was very, very clever. they just didn't get the balance there. Like, it's weird. In the other movie, that girl was very stupid. And in this one, she's like ridiculously clever. Anyways, but otherwise, I enjoyed the movie, so I'll give it something like 7.5, maybe.
Yeah, good entertainment value. This is the kind of, for me, classic Bond stuff that I recognize. Lots of awesome gadgets and chases and things blowing up. I love Judi Dench's M. Finally, there's a woman that I can respect in a James Bond movie.
Oh, no.
No, really, the others. They're beautiful, but you can't really respect them. Yeah, so I'll give it a 7.
I like the fact that they tried to make it more character driven than the last one, or the last two in fact. But I've always felt that the film was slightly frustrating because it didn't quite pull it off right somehow. I don't really know what it was that did wrong. But mostly I think it's good, and of the four Pierce Brosnan films, I think it's second best after GoldenEye. So I'm going to give it 7.5.
Yo, bro, what an awesome Bond movie. Sheesh, bro, Jinx is awesome. No, in fact, she's not. But the Aston Martins, yeah, bro, that car is ridiculously awesome. I don't think a Bond movie could have been better, like the Guardians. And the girls are pretty too. Yes, they're very pretty. What else? The villain, I didn't like the guy with the diamonds on his face.
That's the only good one.
I hated him. Okay. It's gonna have to be an 8 out of 10.
Yeah, I had to try really hard not to fall asleep in that movie.
You failed.
I did. but I watched most of it. Yeah. 6.
I definitely can't give this movie more than 5 out of 10. For the simple reason that there's a few things that I like about it. The list of things that I dislike is much, much longer than the list of things that I do like. There's so many things about that movie that I don't like. So, I'm going to give it 5 out of 10. The only reason I'm not giving it 4 is that I've given You Only Live Twice 5 out of 10, and that's actually my least favourite Bond movie. So I can't give it lower than that. Otherwise I would be giving it 4, but... Yeah, 5 out of 10. Very, very difficult film to sit through, I'm afraid, at this stage of a Bond marathon. If it was earlier on in the series, it might be manageable, but 20 movies in, this is not really the sort of thing you want to be watching. Casino Royale.
Yes.
It's a very, very good movie. Daniel Craig is excellent as James Bond. The script is fantastic. Very good action scenes. Good suspense. The supporting cast is also very good. The cinematography is very beautiful. David Arnold's music is excellent. Frankly, I can go on listing things that I like about that movie forever. And finding things that I dislike about it is very, very difficult. So, I don't think it's as good as A Rush of Love, so I'll just rate it 0.5 lower, so 9.5 out of 10.
I kind of tried to stay awake at one point, but otherwise it was an okay movie. Guess I deserve that. No, I didn't. It was an okay movie. I'm not sure if it's better than GoldenEye, really. So I'll have to give it a 9.
Looking forward to Quantum of Solace.
Yes, bro. I've been waiting for this moment since Friday morning, actually. So it's been a long wait, I must say.
The name's Bond. James Bond.
awesome movie. Ah, that was ridiculously awesome. I don't know, I'm lost for words. 10 out of 10, most deaf. Yes, 10 out of 10.
Quantum of Solace, 8.5. Which is possibly my highest rating. Awesome action scenes, awesome footage, good locations, good plot, good acting, not too much corniness. Yeah, I liked it. So probably my favorite that I saw in this marathon.
I think Quantum of Solace is definitely a worthy follow-up to Casino Royale.
Worthy.
But I don't think it matches Casino Royale in any department. I think it's a good film, but overall, I think Casino Royale is sort of better in every way possible. But having said that, I still rate it very highly amongst the Bond films. I like the kind of simplicity of the concept. Doesn't get too bogged down in elaborate plotting or anything like that. And although the script seems quite thin, a lot of the scenes are very, very packed with sort of character development and emotional material, which is quite unique, I think, in the Bond movies. So, 8 out of 10.
Bond? I need you back.
I never left.
Just keeps me going.